Saga.
So are we starting, or?
It's a dark night and a stormy night. Nope, it's a dark and stormy night as the bright moon glows, and in the distance, a wolf howls. You dive into a fantastical journey into the dark castle of imagination below. The door to the castle swings open wide, and you gaze briefly as magic and melee decks the macabre and a masterful dance of malicious malign. You turn and head down the dark steps of the castle, where fearful flying falcons face fuming fanged phantasms of evil. And the dark red door with a silver snake handle opens to a library full of specters and spacious slithering serpents as Tasha swirls her magically lit flame to her cauldron below, serving in the seething and surreal. She swirls her staff in the homebrewed realm of wonder and fantasy, where the ruin of riches that befall you rely on polyhedral deities. A heart-shaped skull comprised of the fumes of the homebrew rise to meet your gaze as you plunge forward into
her astral realm full of demons and angels, elves and magic, dungeons and dragons.
Twerking?
Is that a little last time best Dungeons and Dragons. We're in the bar afterlife. Dun 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 dun. And there's some exposition about Sylvania's backstory. Something about dead relatives. Lilden hacks into the computer and finds a bunch of blackmail material along with a very disturbing video involving some guns and a light up collar. Seems kinky. We play dress up before going to the club. Once we're there, we descend into the basement called the Nine Hells. Not to be confused with the Seventh Hell, which is something else. Crystal? Maybe Crystal? Crystal? Nice. Between a drunk white girl hitting on the guards, hacking the vending machines to spit out dildos, and starting a fight, the guards get fed up. Roll for initiative! About 15 guards turn into a fine blue digital mist. Everyone gets 103 XP per player and 2,000 credits, along with 15 pistols between the group. Sylvania looks up into a security camera and makes some sort of vague threat to the queen. Four more guards appear outside the doorway, along with an upset woman asking who dares fuck up her club. It's the Queen Cobra, and she's got glitch, and she knows Sylvania, and she blows fire at Alceris. She warns about coming back to finish the job, but for some reason leaves instead of just finishing it right now. BT dubs, Crystal's dead. We're back in the apartment and take a long rest. Ass in. Glitch does some hacking and finds the door we need to get through. We find out that Glitch wants to become the alpha of this level in the world, and the only way to help us is if we help him slaughter a bunch of people. Sylvania says we're headed to Areola Tower. But for now, we alt F4 out of this disaster. Hopefully it autosave. And now, the continuing adventures of the homebrew, the Silver Saga.
You guys have changed, had a long rest, and are outside in the daytime, just outside Arasaka Tower. Hang on for me one second. Or Areola Tower, rather.
Of course. Areola, yep. Not Arasaka. We're not going to get sued.
We're not going to get sued. Hang on for me one second while I drop in this picture of where you guys are at. So far in the front of the entrance is only two
are
guards.
Are we in Vegas?
I hope so.
Big money, baby.
Bet it all on black. Anyway, so you guys are at the entrance to Arasaka Tower. You guys have all changed, had a long rest. You see two guards in front of the entrance to Arasaka Tower holding rifles.
Kill them.
All right. Well, that's it. And so, yeah, you are at the entrance, and one of the guards looks wearily at your party before holding up their rifle closer to themselves. Wait, what do you do?
Wearily or warily?
What's the difference? Yeah, we're going to say warily. It's Nope, never going to. We're going to say warily. So he's wah, the entire like time.
Wario?
You mean,
yeah, while he looks, while he looks at your party, he goes, wah!
Like Wily, like
no,
Dr.
Carl,
Wily?
No, Carl, that's a coyote.
He says, I'll get you, Mega Man. And then he holds his rifle closer to himself. Dr. Wily. That's a good joke. That's... Alexa, shuffle my playlist Mech Anus Level 3.
Every time.
Your liked songs from David's Spotify.
Okay, that's not it. Alexa, stop.
Alexa, I'm going to stop you right there.
Alexa, shuffle my playlist Mech Anus 3.
Shuffling your playlist Mech Anus 3 on Amazon Music.
That's amazing.
It's, oh, it's yeah.
So, yeah, so what do you do?
I try not to throw up.
I mean, are these guards friendly? Can we just flash our badges and go right in? Just
like, where are the badges that you have? Alexa, volume 1.
These aren't the badges you're looking for.
Nice.
Do you really want to go through this plan of action?
Well, it's either that or blow their heads off.
What if I would like to say, hey boys, we just got to sneak in real quick here. I'm just interested to see how that would go over.
Roll a charisma check.
I just watched Picard season 1 again, and I want to tell the guards, choose to live.
Choose to live. So yeah, it's amazing.
Well, then Jericho, you and Leolin roll charisma checks.
I just rolled an 8.
Yeah, I see that.
Mm-hmm. Is that enough? That's high enough.
Yeah.
It's high enough.
the guards look at you and you're like, I'm sorry, official business only.
Okay, I want to retaliate again and say, I'm officially going in there, motherfucker.
Oh, the guard to the right holds his rifle at you and says, not while I'm alive, you're not.
I fry optic on the guard on the right.
Roll a wisdom.
Outstanding.
You manage to blind the guard quickly as he drops his rifle and goes for his eyes and just kind of starts screaming. The guard on the left then starts to raise his rifle. What do you do?
Somebody better fry his optic.
Do it again.
Say, like, yeah.
So at this point, yeah. So Jekyll Ghani has already fried optics on the one on the left. Who's doing the optic frying this time?
So are we fighting?
I guess.
I haven't decided yet.
roll for initiative.
I mean, I tried nicely to walk in there. They wouldn't let us. So.
There's only two. I'm not, and one of them is blinded.
Let's do Fry's Circuit on the other one, just to mix it up.
There we go.
Okay. Who's doing the fry?
I'll do it.
Okay. Roll a wisdom, please.
Shouldn't mine be charisma?
Yes. Alexa, volume 2.
12.
Ooh.
The guard feels something trying to attack his mind, and he shakes it off real quick. And points his rifle at you. He then takes 3 shots at the party itself.
Up.
Shots ring out all through the lobby while the other guard is, again, still on the ground, reeling, holding his eyes. You manage to hear a ping, ping, ping as bullets ricochet off of staircases and just past your heads, pinging off the building itself. What do you do?
Can we say remark that, upon the fact that they really should have better hiring practices for the accuracy of the guards in the front of this giant tower.
These OSHA standards. What did you say?
I'm gonna jump in for Pinnaman here and say that while the guard is distracted shooting at thin air, he sneaks up behind him and snaps his neck.
Roll a dexterity. Like also, if you could do it in the Pinnaman voice, that would be really great.
There we go.
No.
Okay, well, that's sorry.
Fair. That's
can't
fair.
Win them all, folks. Can't win them all. You try to get past the guard as he's shooting, but much like when Superman saw the Flash trying to sneak up behind him, the guard, as he's pulling the trigger, starts to notice Brenneman coming from the right side of him. Points his rifle over at Pinnaman to the right side. What do you do? What does the rest of the party do, rather?
Can I want to go for, like, because at this point the other guy's grabbing his eyes, so
yeah.
I think I want to go ahead and use like cripple movement, so that way we could just burst and get out of here and just get through the doors without having to kill anybody. I guess
I want you to roll a wisdom, please.
Okay. Wisdom it is.
I love this, guys. Let's keep getting our low rolls out on these two guys.
Don't worry, there's a lot of low rolls to come.
Oh my god.
Yeah, apparently.
You try to use cripple movement. There is a pause in the shooter's movement as he almost clicks his trigger again at Pinnaman, and nothing happens. He is startled, but he shakes his hand and wipes off your attempt at crippled movement. What do the rest of you do?
So
I'm gonna try to shoot these motherfuckers.
Now I feel like Leolin, you already tried to have your turn. Let's see what Belarus does.
Well, I thought this was a free for all.
It is, but yeah. You know, you have attempted to do some stuff at the other guy, so you know, only fair.
Okay, so I have a disguise kit. So what I'm gonna do?
Okay.
In a very that's cartoonish right in front fashion,
of I step I'm into the disguise I step into the craft services RV.
Yeah, I'm gonna disguise myself as an intern. I have coffee. I'm trying to get a sentence. Okay, I'm gonna say. I'm going to persuade everyone that what's happening out there doesn't involve my party. We are interns. We have the coffee. And boy, howdy, if we get in there. Boy, howdy, if we get in there late, they shall be very upset with us. And there will be consequences.
Roll a charisma with advantage, please.
Yes, sir. We'll do that. Would you like a performance or persuasion by chance?
Persuasion sounds more what you're trying to do.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. That's a good no. All right.
Get it, Belly!
The better of the rolls. Oh, no, come back. Was 25. It was a dirty 25.
Standing.
You cartoonishly, while this man is reaching for his rifle again, you, like a sim, pull up a shower curtain that covers you entirely, and there are some movements silhouetted behind the shower curtain. The shower curtain goes ahead and just pulls down and is disappeared from view, and you are in a button-up shirt, a black tie, and some black dickies, as well as some nice shoes. Go up to the guard and say what you said, basically. And he puts his weapon at his side and says, "I'm sorry, sir. I didn't realize this was a training exercise. By all means, up to the second floor, floor 50, please."
All right, thank you. Now, I believe I was told that you will have an access card for us to get to all the different levels and offices necessary.
I wasn't aware of such.
That's okay. I'll just take yours.
Oh, but Jerry has the access card. Jerry, do you have? And then you look over at Jerry and he, I just didn't. Why? Why does everybody have to do this to me? It was my Friday. And he still rides around on his, on the floor. Well, I guess Jerry, and he, the guard goes over to his writhing around on the floor friend and kind of picks his pocket. Comes up with an access card attached to a lanyard, and he hands it to you and says, yes, this should access the main five floor penthouse levels at the top there.
Okay, all the way to the top 5 floor penthouse level.
Five.
I would like to also just state that Elsaris is looking Grim Reaper as fuck. That's all.
Yeah, the guard is very intimidated as Silver, then Glitch, then Elsaris kind of follow the rest of your party in.
What cool walk do we do, guys?
The walk of shame after those rolls. I'd like to do like a Kill Bill entry. Dun, dun. I don't know how it fucking goes, but you know it. Yeah. But like not like Kill Bill style, like Team of America World Police style.
Where we just that makes sense. Yeah.
Pump it in there, yeah. Dun, dun, dun.
World Police, stand in the ground.
I would like to slowly approach the door, but then instead of walking through it, I glitch out and appear on the other side.
Whoa! the guard drops his gun and goes, "Oh shit!" And the other guard, I can't believe this is supposed to be my day off, and still.
Hey, shut up! I wasn't even supposed to be here today.
Chad shoots Jerry.
To be fair, shit like that does always happen on those days.
Yeah, true that.
This puts him out of his misery.
Yeah, Jerry is silenced.
Fix your optics though, can't you? Like, I mean, if we fry somebody's optics, it's not necessarily for life though.
Yeah, right? No, it didn't have to be this way, but you know, okay. Whatever. That's
you know,
hey,
you win some.
Hey, good thinking, Billy. You know, like that cartoon thing you did when you had changed into those clothes, man, fuck, that was funny as shit. First off, because it was like reminding me of cartoons, but also like very smart idea ripping that guy's fucking access card off there. That was good thinking.
Oh, yes, thank you. What are cartoons?
You know, I don't know. I just, you know, it, I don't, the word I just, popped in my head.
I just came from like
Silver goes, it's one of those. Woods. And the she points to a lazy security guard, not really paying attention, watching Looney Tunes on his color TV.
Lego just announced a series of Looney Tunes minifigs.
What? Oh, fun! Hey, outstanding. Such. I dig that. Yeah, that's cool. Maybe Marvin Gabby the Martian. The
goat. They should bring back Gabby the goat. Remember Gabby the goat?
They should bring back what's the cow? I can't remember.
Bessie? No, was it Bessie?
Was it Bessie? I feel like it might have been Bessie.
So the first circle of hell.
Yep. So you guys are in Arasaka Tower. You're you're in the main. You have taken the elevator up to the main penthouse floor. Hang on for me 1 second.
Take a shot of Jack Angle from a digital flash. Yeah,
you take a shot of Jack Angle. Let me pull up your guys' stuff real quick.
That's right, because it RoboCop's out of my leg now.
Oh shit, that's right.
I'm pretty sure that's what he said.
Yep.
Jack Angles.
All right.
Eat with my butt.
Hmm. Let's see.
For an hour. For an hour. It's horrible.
All right. And then I will share screen so that way.
I'll bear time?
Yeah.
And then let me pull this over here so you guys don't take a peek behind the curtain. All right, so you have reached into Arasaka Tower level 1 in the penthouse region. You arrive at this area right here. And yeah, you are into the main lobby portion.
There's the lobby portion?
Where it says main lobby.
That makes sense. Yeah. Read it before.
So, so that's where you guys are at. What do you do?
Walk in like some motherfucking bosses.
I rave a little bit because these lights are amazing.
Do we
know where the queen is located at or whatever? Like in
to kind of give you a recap about what you're supposed to be doing in this particular building, Glitch has told you that the door is located at the very main center at the top of Arasaka Tower, presumably on the fifth level of the penthouse suite. You guys are on the first level of the penthouse suites. You have to get to the elevator in order to access each floor because the stairs are down.
So the stairs are down as in they don't function?
They don't function anymore. For whatever reason, the doors to the stairs have been closed and locked.
Okay,
it's very much a fire hazard that should not be existing in this particular
guys, this battery. We can't use
They're
told you to
plug
them in. I would like to use one of my features and where I could send a message, and I would like to contact OSHA.
I look at
pull
Billy
a code
and
on them. Yeah,
Billy, you got any more of them disguises, man? Maybe we could sneak through, and them guards won't fucking give a shit.
I do have two.
You guys should probably put your own tokens and stuff within the map. I suppose I probably should have told you that.
Well, I think we can't see our. Really
we don't cool. have access to our own tokens. You
oh
have
shit!
Uploaded
oh my god! All right, my bad. Give me a moment.
Oh, I can just pick one. I mean, like,
yeah, I found this wolf.
I'll be a tree guy.
There you go.
I love those.
It's so stupid. You guys are so dumb. Let's see.
I'm gonna sit on the couch.
Okay. So that's where you guys are at.
So we don't have enough. We don't have enough costumes for everybody to be.
I mean, we can maybe spread some.
This feels like a pretty standard Shinra tower situation. So I think if we just go one at a time and time the waves, we'll miss all the guards.
You know what? That's a
I mean, I don't have enough evidence to refute it. So I mean, like, why not?
Can I? While they're getting the costumes together, can I hack the computer and see if there's some sort of alarm I can set off lower in the building to distract all these guards?
Sure. Roll an intelligence check.
Three.
Did you say three? Okay. Yeah, you find nothing but porn. That's
Could you please put some
I start to jerk off.
Yeah.
The flash drive.
Yeah, I got one on me right here. I'll start copying those files.
Oh my god.
Come on, man.
You download 20 gigs full of furry porn and you manage to you jerk off to only 5 gigs, so that's great.
Yeah, give me those big old furry eyes.
Yeah, what? there's just thousands of pictures.
And that screen mouth I know you're looking through.
Yeah, I guess. you go through tons of, I don't know, pictures, I guess. And
you're saying click, furry, click, click, but all click, I'm click. Looking at is like mascot costumes now.
So
that's what I was thinking. When I think of furries, that's what I think of as people fucking in mascot costumes.
You go down a very weird rabbit hole, and then you this goes on for about 20 minutes. Nobody is alerted to your presence, and you're still in the lobby.
Take 3d12 psychic damage. Yes.
Jesus.
Check for dehydration.
So I have a question. Are these doors?
I gotta tell you a
story. Yes, those are doors.
Okay. So when you when you go watch a if you go to the Milwaukee Brewers stadium and you watch a Brewers game, they have a thing. They have the sausage race, and it's
what?
It's three people that race in because Clement sponsors it or whatever, because they're from Milwaukee's. So there's three sausages that race, and it's people dressed up in giant mascot costumes, but they're sausages. So it'll be like nice. A chorizo, a brat, a hot dog. Nice. And every time I think about furries, I also think about
mascots, just like the Twinkie guy just getting sausages. In there and just
hold on, I gotta find it counts,
I'll just kind of go in there. Yeah. Don't count, right?
That's ridiculous. I'll find a picture. You've got to see this shit.
That's so funny.
Okay, so these are doors, and then this. So here's where I'm getting at. So Pinnaman and I are pretty proficient. Nice. I like the.
Oh
the
man.
Rod. Yeah,
broad.
That's oh, pretty man.
Funny.
Yeah. The chorizo is just a little.
Chorizo. That happened.
No, okay. So we're pretty proficient in stealth. So what I'm thinking is that we could exit out of here and jump over here and take care of these two guards, maybe before anybody else is alerted. And I don't know, maybe we could cause a distraction somehow to get everybody away from that main lobby. That's where my head's at.
I mean, there's also a couple storerooms we could.
Yeah, what if we go in one of the storerooms and like cause a commotion so that they think there's stuff in there, but then we leave and just go back into the main lobby?
Ooh, I have an idea. Ooh, yeah. Oh, wait, never mind. I can't use magic. I'm going to go back.
Right. You can use cybernetics.
Cybernetic. Oh, shit. What
alternatively, we could also just walk through the door and slaughter everyone.
Yeah,
that's
probably what he's getting at.
Can you send me what that's always what we're doing. Having a change of heart here in Areola Tower.
He's trying to get sick.
All right, we might as well just bust through then. If y'all are ready to do this, I pull out dual rifles. All right, well, I mean, I did want to do it, but give me a shot of Jet Gangle. Let's get in there and do it.
DM,
let's roast these sausages.
What El Saris can do that's above and beyond. He's got hot shot.
He's got a hot shot. He's got sonic scream. He's got pop.
Yeah, so I'm shooting.
Anyways, I started blasting.
It'll take me a moment to find the notes for what El Saris can do.
All right, well, we'll keep going while we're looking.
Yeah, we'll keep going while somebody else gets it for you.
There was, I thought there was there a hot shot, or am I confusing that with something else?
No, pop, hot shot, and
sonic scream.
Sonic scream, yeah.
Something else. All right, cool.
I'd like to make a big commotion and then climb in the couch, and then when everybody comes in to check out, everybody goes into like store one or store two and just chills there. And so I'll be the big distraction to lure everybody into the room, right? So I'll get in the couch, but then I have to emerge like Frank and I was sending Philadelphia, like I just put in the Discord, and I have to emerge from the couch like that. And then everybody comes in, we slaughter them all in the same way. That's what I like to do for real.
How did you get in the couch?
Well, I mean, that's my. I have a high proficiency in stealth, so I don't need to tell you. What do I got to roll, DM? Let's make this happen.
To get in the couch, you roll nothing to get into the couch. But to be stealthy as a big bubble in a leather couch is going to be quite hard.
I'm pretty good at stealth, though.
Hard.
Heyo. So
what kind of coach is this?
Yeah,
is
this like, proficient in athletics.
This is like definitely a black leather couch.
A black leather couch. It's very comfy.
Is there,
it's this one that I'm on it. I'm on it right now. This
oh my God.
This little couch that I'm on right now. I don't know if it, maybe I'll move my guy. That's the couch.
Silver says, "Well, I guess I'm down for whatever." And she hides behind the desk.
Yep. Well, or go in one of the storerooms on the side, and then when we get everybody in there from the distraction, because I'll be like, "Ah!" or set off, you know, like pop off a couple of shots so they all run in the room or something, and then.
Bellaros and Pinnaman are in storage room two. Okay.
And even so,
I think I'm gonna hit up the bathroom.
Can you do some cocaine because this is cyberpunk or what? Okay.
I also want to look around a bit here.
Yeah.
Okay. You I'm can roll get an investigation check, but I'm gonna make it easier for you. There's nothing but files in here, unfortunately.
How are they filed? Is it alphabetically?
Alphabetical.
Is it by subject?
Yeah, like, what are they're, we they're done. What's they're the done system? Alphabetical via clients first, then subject matter.
Would it be a good idea to have some of the clients' information? As far as like having some blackmail, what is this company again? There's probably
are there emails included, and can I sell them to Turkish hackers?
There you go.
I'm gonna say there's emails included, but you don't know any Turkish hackers.
So close.
Yeah, you. There are copies of emails in here, but they all have different prices in there. You're not really sure what is going on with that. As far as what you know Arasaka does, Arasaka is, from what you could tell, a weapons company.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
If this is so far in the future, why haven't they moved to a paperless office yet?
Let's not, huh? Because they can afford not to.
Because papers can't be hacked.
Because capitalism, you know? Yeah.
Don't anybody think of the trees.
Yeah, but we're in here.
That's true.
And we're not trees.
That's, well, technically, I'm a trash, so.
What are you?
I mean, I'm pretty close, like, getting close that's to true. That dream here.
Leolin, where are you during all this?
Is there a shredder in this office?
There is one located turtles. In each of the in each of the storage rooms with the
I feel like clients. We should shred all of their client files.
Just sabotage the fuck out of this company before we
do. To be fair, they left all of their client files in storerooms next to the main lobby, which is unmanned.
Pretty dumb, yeah.
This is not
next
our
time,
fault.
Go paperless, dickheads.
Okay. Is that...
I am going to right-hand side. That pizza from the other time.
It's unpersoned.
That's...
Yes, there you go. Be more.
It is unpersoned. You're right. So you all right? So what I can tell here, Bellaros, you are in the bathroom, presumably shitting. Pippin and Jekogane, you were in the storage room too. Are you burning away files, or was this a pipe dream?
We are bumping out a quickie. Actually,
nicely done. Nicely done.
I mean, get it in.
You're like, guys, we're gonna burn these files. Don't come in here.
It's so good that Pinnaman thinks he sees his spirits.
Oh God! Gets his ghosties back.
Yeah. But he just comes. That's
grow up. Okay.
Yeah. So you ever had one of those like euphoric experiences where you're all lightheaded afterwards? It's one of those things.
This all checks out.
Yeah. A little bit of like spots at first, and then he thinks he sees the spirits, but he realizes it's all in his head. And so Ivana, what is she doing? I'm going to assume that Leolin has control of her. So Leolin, what is Ivana doing this time?
What was she doing the last time?
She was just following you guys.
Fair. Wait, what are we trying to get done?
The idea is that you're supposed to head to the elevators.
I mean, I thought we were going to walk in and blast.
Yeah, so what I'm trying.
Then there was a lot of different plans that occurred here.
All I did was fucking ice cream, and everything changed.
So originally, I wanted to run across and get into the elevator by killing these two people, but we gotta take care of these guys too. So we decided we're just gonna go and slaughter them all. So I'm creating a distraction by hiding in the couch here, and then making a lot of noise. So whenever all these guys run in, like, what the fuck is going on? I emerge from the couch, like the Frank from Always Sunny gift that I put in the Discord there, and like all naked, and they're like, what the fuck? And then you guys bust in the room and shoot them up. Just shoot them up. What?
So So both of us are over in storeroom number one, waiting on the guards.
Okay, great.
Wait, why is Sylvania out? Is this Sylvania?
Silver. She's what? So Silver was here because she wasn't really sure about the plan. So where should she be?
Also hiding.
That's your character.
Yeah, well, Silver would just hide underneath the desk.
You know, here's a real question. Where should Elsa?
I'm not saying she does a good job. I'm just saying she hides under the desk.
6 foot seven, like.
It's actually like balanced on her, lifted up a little bit, but like, you know, whatever.
Throw up.
I'm gonna hide behind this shrubbery. I believe that's a shrub.
Yeah. Elsaris's form, for whatever reasons, like seems to fit in perfectly as almost a metallic pillar within this room. So
the shrub is tall.
That's a real nice shrub behind that monolith you got there, is what people would say. Yeah. So who's doing the distracting? What are you doing?
I suppose I was thinking pop off shots and then scream really loud and they run into the main lobby. Because we don't got any like loud explosion type things unless somebody's got something in their cod pieces they're not telling us about.
Well, we do have several pistols that we haven't talked about.
Oh yeah, maybe we just dump them all in the middle of the room. What the fuck? These people. I'm just saying.
Is this what we're doing?
Unless someone has a better plan.
All right, here's what we're gonna do. Okay, Jericho, here's what I need you to do.
Okay.
I need you to take some of the powder out of the bullets from the 100 pistols that we've won. And then when we're all in place, I need you to set a spark or shoot that pile of powder. And
listen,
it will create
some
aid.
Billy, I'm gonna be real with you. I just came from these words.
He talks from the couch, so the couch actually kind of like pulsates out with each word that he says.
Take the shooty pills, take the shooty pills, and pull them apart until the sand comes out of the shooty pills from.
Oh yeah, the fucking sand. Hold on.
Yes.
Fucking sand. Gotcha.
All right, everything's good here. All right.
Then make fire to the pile, and
That shit explodes, man! What are you, crazy?
Oh, you get it.
No. Billy.
But I'm still in the couch, Billy. I don't know what you want me to do for the couch.
So
Billy,
you guys go ahead and take a bunch of bullets out of the pistols. You have emptied out the gunpowder in, I'm going to say, a big pile on the floor. Is that right?
Yeah, it takes about 10 minutes.
No,
yeah.
you gotta put it in something. Gunpowder needs
Fuck, you're right.
It's
not like the movies where you just make a trail.
Yeah, you can't just do that. That's not how that works.
We should probably use a cartoon change.
We should stuff it in the plant.
Never.
And then blow up the plant.
There you go.
And then it'll be on fire, and then they'll be like, what the fuck, a fire? And then I'll...
Yeah.
Silver is just like inserting random pistols and rifles that she's found and just like putting them on the in a big pile on the floor.
So should Elsaris move from
there's
that
so
truck?
Many things.
As you do.
I feel like we just need to execute this plan. I'm just going to keep adding stuff into the
I'm
room.
Going
like,
to stand
I
on top
no
of
idea
this
what's happening.
Right here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, so
this is going to be a success. I can tell you right now.
Jericho, you wait until there's a big pile of guns and gunpowder on this floor here. You set off a shot.
Can we assume that we move this? Sorry to interrupt you, but
yeah, sure.
We assumed we move this thing into the center so that we don't blow up Belarus while he's shitting, because like he's almost done.
God, you're shitting, like, buddy.
Yeah, sure. That makes sense to me.
Thank you.
All right. So you have positioned this shrubbery in the middle of the thing, surrounded it with guns and gunpowder. And Jericho, you have set off a shot. Let's roll a d20 to see how big the shot is.
Ooh, yes.
Does he get what you always want to hear?
Yeah.
Right. Does he get advantage or like some kind of like plus?
I'll say you get advantage. I mean, like, you guys have spent quite a long time building up this pile of death.
There it is. Yeah, right.
Burn Areola Tower to the ground. Quest over.
Yeah.
At 20, son.
Seriously?
Outstanding.
Oh my god. This is
wonderful.
The explosion is so loud, it knocks a hole into level 2 of the penthouse. There's a big hole in the middle of the roof, and guards start to line up at the door and enter into this room. I'd say now is a good time where we can.
I was gonna say it.
Roll for initiative.
Holy fuck! I'm so glad I got a nat 20 on that and didn't get like a 3.
Holy shit!
Alexa, shuffle my playlist. D&D action.
Shuffling the playlist. All right, initiative. On Amazon Music. Ooh. Okay.
Well, I got a natural 20 for rolling for initiative, so that means all my attack rolls are going to be 2s.
Yeah, right.
Pinnaman also got a nat 20, and I rolled my third 4 of the night, so...
No more 4s.
What?
Outstanding.
I'm going to get Elsaris in just a second.
Sure. No, I'll auto roll for him. Don't worry about it.
Really?
Yeah. Well, it's just initiative.
So is it all
there's like a plus something to his initiative?
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, no, you roll for him then. Sorry.
Wait, is it all the guards except for the two?
Oh, he's got no plus.
Yeah, except for these three up at the top here. That's all.
They're going to be able to see the inside that. The two that are... Hold on, let me do the thing. As soon as this door opens... Uh-huh. They're going to be able to see the Travis Sham mockery that is happening over here, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Good to know. I can't believe we pulled this off.
Okay. It is Pinnaman's turn. Pinnaman, what are you doing? Pinnaman, you have advantage, by the way, because you are in the other room and the guards don't see you and Jekogani yet.
If we could take like a 38-second bathroom and drink break, Pinnaman could answer himself.
I'm super okay with that, actually, yeah.
Osmode.
Nice. I'm so glad.
Like, we're not save quitting yet, but...
No, yeah. Let's see. Save... Just in case. Yeah. It's like Fallout and you're about to like, you know, verse off against a couple of mutants, but you're not quite at the level where you should be versing off against mutants. So you just kind of
just quick save there.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
that way
the
next time you open it up, you can fucking run away as quick as you can.
Yeah.
I'm not doing that again.
You get it. What are you drinking, Carl? Tab?
It looks like it. It is a Fulton.
Oh, Heart
grapefruit.
Nice.
Is it good?
Does it taste like Fresca?
The Fulton hard ciders actually taste pretty much like exactly what a big old glass full of fruit would taste like. They're pretty good.
Right. Sounds pretty good.
I like that. Like the lime one tastes like lime rinds. I don't know.
Lime rinds.
It's bitter as fuck.
Kind of, a little bit, yeah. God, it's good. They're really not sweet at all.
No.
which I like.
I guess that's a good thing, because when they taste too sweet, you know that your tummy is just going to be like, I'm eating green poop tomorrow.
Yeah, it's going to be a terrible day.
Gut rotten hangovers.
I didn't want to have diarrhea, but here we are.
Hello.
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 Sorry for being late. Thanks, guys.
Whatever.
No worries. Man, it's good to see you.
Thanks. Good to see y'all. I hear it's my turn, and
maybe we should bring you up to speed of our current situation.
Yeah,
so we found some free porn and blew up a plant.
Hey, oh, the porn! I forgot about the porn. Oh my god,
that's primo.
Primo furry porn. Whenever we want to have access.
Primo.
Yeah, we got
primo
we got 20...
as you could get with people in costumes. I guess I don't know.
What we accomplished today was we got 20 gigs of furry porn on a flash drive, and we blew up a plant in an office.
Yeah, and I'm currently in a couch.
What did the plant do?
It needed to be used as a distraction.
It was a means to an end.
Also,
but you should have responded with this. It knows what it did.
It knows what it did.
Dirty, sweaty sex. I mean, like, hey. You're in the storeroom. We were like, it's happening.
It's canon. You came so hard, you thought you saw your ghosts.
Yes, that's right. So we haven't really accomplished much.
So I just say
it's a lot of fun playing with you guys, D&D.
Oh, contrary, we accomplished a lot.
Yeah, it depends on how you really look at it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like last episode where we figured out our dick size right at the beginning of the episode. We got a lot of stuff out of the way, so that's good.
So this is where you're at, and Pinnaman, it is your turn. What do you do?
Cool. I'm going to slide my clothes back on real quick. And I want to.
Crude.
I know, right? Hey, I gotta like keep some decorum.
Right.
Anywho, I'm gonna walk straight.
Nobody wants to walk around with their bussy out.
What the fuck? Bussy. I assume I know what that means. I hope I know. I'm pretty sure I know what that means. I don't know.
It means exactly what you think.
Okay. Yeah. All right. I'm like, yes. That's just, is he saying it like, oh, that's fun. Yeah. All right.
You know, like the guy bussing the tables at the restaurant.
Right. Right. The
that's
bussy.
What it means. Yep.
Yeah.
A busser.
A man just flaunting around his bussy all over the place.
Isn't
yeah.
That
no,
the
that's...
same as a fluffer.
It's a lot of, I love how you and I use the same stuff with the siblings already.
Sorry. I'm sorry for being your brother.
Yeah.
Mother.
Yeah, I will. Pinnaman, what are you doing?
You know, I thought I heard something in the other room, so I actually want to creep out the other door. And sneak around and surprise these other guards that are behind the door in the middle. Yeah.
Okay.
I want
to
sneak up on these guys.
I can dig that. I'm going to say you're closer to the one on the left. So I'm going to give you advantage on this one because, again, you have been in the storage space. So what exactly are you trying to do?
Well, you know, I have two rifles, six shots. I think I'm going to go for the first one, and then if I get it, go for the other one.
Okay, roll again. Roll with advantage.
All right.
Does Jericho and I need to roll off for a second nail in? No. The D&D beta encounter stuff allows me to or auto kind of fixes that. So. I don't need you guys to decide between if three of you roll 21, it'll auto decide who goes first.
I.e. it puts everybody in alphabetical order.
Exactly.
The intro's like, damn it.
Okay.
Ooh.
Outstanding.
Yeah, let's I'm gonna give you plus +5 for your damage. Let's roll beautiful beam damage, please.
Grow up.
Shut up. by the way, for any DMs using this encounter thing from D&D Beyond, should anybody go after me, double up or even triple up on the XP that it gives you, because it's horse shit. you guys should have been almost like another level at this point, and
I mean, you want to
we're not even half. Yeah,
so
just whatever they give us, I guess, just multiply it by
outstanding.
You cap this motherfucker on the left straight through, headshot. You hear, oh god, there's a thing that I was gonna do for this. Give me a moment.
Please tell me it's just T-Pain.
Well, whatever. I had a sound effect, but apparently I didn't add it. Yes, it's T-Pain. You did it, headshot. And that's what you hear when you.
And now you, that's canon.
Yeah, yep. And so you swiftly put a hole in the left one's head and end his life quickly. You have taken out a guard. It is now. Give me a moment. Hang on.
The food of your choice will end your life tonight.
Belarus, it's your turn.
So that it took six shots. It took six shots to kill one dude in the head.
No, you just riddled him with bullets.
He said he wanted to aim at another person with the second rifle.
Is that what you said?
Yeah, I said I was going for the guy.
You were going for both of them?
If I got him, I was going
for the guy. Okay. In that case, I will say this. You have still taken out the one guard, but you have done six damage to the one on the right. So this one right here.
Coolio.
Cool. again, that's kind of you, because you had it on, added up all that damage together, right? Yeah. Okay. Good. Yeah. Then we're good. Belarus, it's your turn. What are you doing?
Yes. I am going to, as swiftly as possible, but still taking care not to get sit in my fur, wipe my ass. And I will not. Now, forgive me. I will not flush, nor will I be washing my hands, because,
oh my god, okay.
Unfortunately, I need to surprise the people who are outside of this door.
Uh-huh.
So, how did the doors open? Are they like a Star Trek
swoosh? Star Trek style, yeah.
Fuck. Okay, so he's gonna, I guess, walk. You know what? He can wash his hands. It's probably silent. I'm gonna wash my hands. But I'm not gonna flush, okay?
Okay, yeah, good. And good, you show him.
I pull out both of my newly found rifles.
Rifles, yes.
And I the door swooshes open. I walk out and I point one rifle to this guy and the other rifle to this guy.
Okay. They are severely shocked. Roll with advantage.
Can they also
make
be
sure there's a smell coming from their bathroom? This,
oh!
I don't think it needs to be said, but I'm gonna go ahead and say it anyway. Attached to your foot is a piece of stuck toilet paper. It's very long.
Three seashells?
It's very long. Instead they use their own receipts. And so you have like a cub receipt length of toilet paper attached to your
gosh,
foot.
It's still going.
Yeah, it's wild. You roll with advantage.
Mm. What, how do you want me to roll? You just want me to roll like...
Yeah, you're just doing a dexterity.
Okay. Oh, I can dig that. Ooh, gosh. Help me out. Here we go. Okay, sorry, my best one was a 12.
On the wrong page when I hit it, and it makes me roll.
Outstanding.
You managed to get the both these guards, both on the left and the right. Let's go ahead and roll for that beautiful beam damage, please.
All right, it's three shots per thing, and it's, what is it, 2d8? No.
And somebody, I forgot to take notes.
1d6.
Oh, no, I have to take notes for my own game.
Yeah, right. It's 1d8.
Bows, are you pistol or rifle? What do you?
It's rifles.
1d8
or 1d8 piercing damage. Yeah.
All right, so let's roll for the guy on the left.
Yeah, 1d8 per shot. Yeah, I'm gonna say you're able to get three shots per. Yeah, thank you. You're able to do three shots per rifle. So three shots to the left, three shots to the right.
For the left, okay.
Yeah.
So 9 damage for the guy on the left.
Okay.
Left 9. Okay, right about to be
outstanding.
Outstanding. 8 times 3. Bah, 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 bah. I think I did that right. Yeah, D8. All right, and the guy on the right gets 8.
Okay. And okay, you have came out of the bathroom again with this toilet paper stuck to your right leg, stuck to your right foot rather, and you're bang 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 out of the door. You managed to catch the guard on the right. With a lot of bullets, and the one on the left with only a meager amount of bullets, but hey, it pierces them nonetheless. They're not dead, but they are pretty shook up. It is now... it is now... Jericho's turn. Jericho, what are you doing?
So again, now that we got some guards pouring into the room, I emerge from the couch naked, and almost like... I spin myself slimy from the sweat because we were talking a lot and I was talking a lot and it created a lot of wetness. So I like slide out of the couch.
Yeah.
Just lay on the ground, spread eagle. And the two guards are behind me and my penis is just like, I'm just dangling.
Yeah.
And I say,
hey, wait, boy. Why did you whip your dick out?
I wanted to be true to that scene. So like, I'm kind of mirroring that. I don't know.
Oh, like a
it was warm in that couch.
I had taken off my clothes.
Yeah, and no,
I
he just sweated. He so took much. Off his
clothes. Tell me on the baby yoga the where somebody touched you.
So I say, hey boys, and then I pull out two rifles and bop, 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 bop.
I'm going to give you advantage on this because not only are you sliding on out of this, but there is still a flame in the middle of the room.
Just in case anyone missed it the first time.
So it's almost like you are a fire demon Shinjuku gone to life, naked as fuck, wielding rifles, your penis, your average penis, just kind of flailing around everywhere. You have advantage. Let's go ahead and get dexterity.
All right. It looks at literally exactly
like this. So yeah, yeah. Right. No, it's they see the flame. They're like, oh my god, what is going on? And then a slow naked man just starts to emerge from this. Okay, that's with advantage, Juice.
Wait, what? How much was the advantage?
Are we playing the game or what?
Sorry, advantage is you roll twice, you take the better.
Oh, okay. I see my bad.
Unless I specifically said something like, I give you plus five to damage or.
Much better.
Yeah.
Outstanding.
I assume you have each rifle pointed at each guard, yes?
Correct.
Good. Let's roll some beautiful beam damage. I'm going to give you a plus three to damage. Because again, they're just so shocked by the optics of this particular visual here.
I would fucking hope so.
Yeah.
right, give me one second.
Quick question while he's doing that. Do you have to have line of sight to Fry Optic or Circuit?
Yes.
Thank you.
One second. Oh, there it goes. Oh, nope. Refresh it, and so okay. Here we go. Piercing. And how much was the advantage to the damage? What did you get?
Three.
Okay.
So that's it.
Yeah. One. No, I'm sorry.
That's wait. One rifle is 7 damage. The other rifle is something else. Yeah.
I'm sorry. Okay. So 3 and then boom. Okay, it doesn't matter. I mean, whatever.
Yeah, well, 7 and 12. So whatever.
You choose who gets one. Yeah. So.
So you have fired off the piercing the shoulder of one of the guards, and then goes to these, and then 2 shots rang out and pierced the stomach of the guard on the right. So you have damaged them, but not completely taken them out. It is now Leolin's turn. Leolin, what are you doing?
I'm gonna dual wield my what's it called?
The rifles. Okay. On what exactly?
On these guards. Well, wait, I want to actually go out. I'm going to go out this door. I'm going to go out over here.
All right. The one on the right there.
So yeah, I'm going to try to like shoot both these 2.
Okay. That's fine. I'm going to give you advantage because again, they were already getting pretty fucked up via Belarus. So they are distracted and don't see you before you, pop on out, Reservoir Dog style. Why don't you, roll with advantage.
Well, good thing I have advantage. Oh, great. It went down. So I got an 8. A 9 and an 8.
your heart is bigger than the action that you take itself. You pull out your rifles. You quick do a... And the Star Trek door swings open wide, and you just ring wild with bullets just kind of flying everywhere. The guards kind of do a quick cover, just a duck head down, and ricochets just ping, 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 ping off different metallic objects within the office. But no, you don't manage to hit any of the guards. It is now Silvera's turn. Silvera pops open her mantis blade and jumps down on the guard on the left, striking her T-1000 blade straight through the skull on the guard on the left, and takes him out instantly. It is now El Saris's turn. What is El Saris doing?
El Saris. Let's see here. Now, I'm going to ask a similar question. Does El Saris need line of sight, or does he get that seeing the matrix code?
He's got a little bit of an advantage, so he can see. Let me kind of show you where his he can see up to here. He can see up to here. He cannot see up to here. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that's fair. So like just right behind a wall.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
He's able to see these 3 people.
Okay. So El Saris, he's becoming more aware of how badass he is. And he's like, I'm going to use Sonic Scream.
Nice.
On the one person who's still in here. And I can sense 2 others behind the wall. So he starts floating like in Raised by Wolves. Over okay. The fire.
He thinks he's floating, but he's actually just on his tippy toes.
He's tippy toeing across. But, yeah. You know, he is pretty tall as a Grim Reaper.
Absolutely. So
I want to try to Sonic Scream the 3
that are available to be scrammed at.
Sure. The one in the room with Alceris definitely is frightened by his presence, so I'm going to give you advantage on that.
I'll roll for advantage guy first then?
Yeah. Why don't you roll for advantage guy first, and then we'll roll for the other two.
How would you like for me to do that? Is that going
to
be a...
I want you to roll a wisdom for the one within the room that I give you advantage on.
Wait, should I
move out of the way before he does this?
You're gonna have to do a dexterity saving throw because he's already committed to the act.
Oh, I didn't realize it was gonna be like area of effect and friendly
fire.
Oh,
it definitely is. Yeah.
Good luck.
Think about it, we're not naked in the couch either, man. It just happens.
He's on the ground, so I mean, like, presumably he's in a pretty good spot to.
I was imagining him tippy toeing, like up here, so maybe, somewhere around here, maybe.
Why don't you grab him and kind of put him where you want?
Oh, I gotta put him down first.
Don't put me down.
So perhaps, like, if I go at an angle. Like, I won't be getting Silver and...
Yeah, no, that makes sense. Well, Silver is behind a desk after she had stabbed that guard, so she is not in your
line of sight, so to speak. I'll just scream right in his face and through the wall and get these two guys. You can't see what I'm doing.
I can see you. Yeah. All right, yeah, no, I'll give you advantage on that. So we're just going to give you advantage, and we'll say this roll counts for all three guards.
Now, if Alceris is able to cast magic, which I know he can't, he would cast it against his charisma. Would that be what I use for all my hacks?
Because I'm pretty sure bards have like, yeah. So hacks we want to treat the same as magic. Pretty sure bards use charisma for magic. So yes, charisma is what you would roll.
Plus, all right. So I'm gonna roll. My with advantage, so I'm gonna give you two rolls. We got an 11. Go. And we got a come on.
Scram good, Elsa.
Right, I got an 11 and an 11. I guess I'm supposed to get 11 for Captain Double Ones.
So you let loose with this sonic scream, you and the inflate yourself up a little bit. The guard seems very worried, and he drops his rifle as he starts running out the door. As he starts running out the door, you let loose with your sonic scream. For whatever reason, your mouth, when you scream out Black Canary style, your jaw drops slightly lower than normal. And your mouth opens wider, much like the mummy, the Brendan Fraser style mummy.
Right.
The mouth just kind of like opens to an unnatural length and lets loose with this powerful wave of sonic burst. It destroys the wall that was holding the door to the main lobby there. And it does affect all three of these guards here. I'm going to give you a plus 5 to damage. Yes, thank you very much. I'm going to give you a plus 5 to damage because at this point they are blasted by your scream and they are holding their ears as their bones are being rattled from the inside. Let's go ahead and roll that beautiful bean damage.
How do I damage that again? Did we throw that in?
For Sonic Scream... If I didn't already give it to you, I'm going to say it was 3d8.
I think that sounds right. I can get up to five people, and it's 3d8. I'll remember that.
And in this particular one, it's only going to affect these three. But yeah, no, I think you get it.
So is it 3d8 for each target that I hit?
3d8. Just roll 3d8. Give me the total, and then that applies to each guard. Does that make sense?
Yeah, make it quick. All right.
Yeah.
So each one of them is going to get 12.
Damn. Okay. Let's see. Is that what you rolled?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. 12.
1 + 8 + 3.
And there. And there.
No, it's 1 + 2 + 2 + 1 + 1.
You have bloodied the guard on, let's see, you have bloodied this guard here, and bloodied this guard here, as well as hurt this guard, but he's not bloodied. it is now Thug's turn. Let's go ahead and just get a nice good group roll for this. the guards pull out their rifles and they are shooting wildly at anything that moves. The bullets are ricocheting off of these marble walls and marble floors so much so that they're bringing up dust, kind of covering the battlefield, so to speak. With each bullet that whizzes past the party's head and ears and legs, it brings up more and more dust. And so you guys are basically like clouded, the entire area where you guys are at here. But no shots managed to ring through and hit any of the party themselves. So that's good. Let's see.
So the stormtroopers. Okay.
Yeah, basically it is now Ivanka's. It is now Ivana's turn. What is Ivana doing? Leolin, you have control of Ivana.
Oh. What are some things she can do?
Same well things played that you so can far.
Do. Oh. Yeah. She's standing in the you guys can, well, yeah. So, I mean, does she, does
let's,
her.
Let's just have her start blasting.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So, I assumed you move her somewhere.
Just in the room fires up.
Yeah, and, she's just firing in the room itself.
And blasting up at the walls. She's gonna come over here.
Really does
and,
not like filing cabinets.
No. No. how about she comes up here and she starts there's only one. Yeah, she's gonna she's gonna fire at this this person.
This person over there? Okay, yeah, no. So, Leolin, you have distracted the guard that's kind of over in this area anyway. So, yeah, no, I'm going to... That's definitely legit. I could see her doing that. How far away is it from... That's not bad. Yeah, sure. She's just lining up to get in the line of sight with her rifle. I can dig that. Is she using both of her rifles?
Sure.
Okay, yeah, sure. That makes sense. Let's roll for dexterity, please.
Hopefully she doesn't have any bonuses because I don't know what they are.
No, she doesn't have. Well, I mean, even if she did, I wouldn't know.
10.
She throws multiple rifle shots in the direction of this guard, but the guard kind of hides behind the wall where he is at next to the door and manages to escape each one of her shots. So. It is now.
If she's plus 3, then that would have been a 13.
I thought you said you only rolled a 10. A 10.
Yeah, but she's plus 3 dex.
Oh, okay. All right.
I checked her character sheet and she
does that make a difference?
Dex, so she gets a plus 3.
I think that makes a difference, yeah.
Oh, well. Fantastic.
Yeah, so let's roll that beautiful bean damage then.
I'm assuming she's dual wielding, right?
Yeah, no, she's dual wielding. So well, you made a cannon, yeah.
Yeah. 1d8.
Take a shot at Jack Gangle naked.
No. Doesn't ever.
Oh, it's 1d8 plus, so it's
3d8.
It's 68.
Yeah. It's 68. Three per. Yeah, you get it.
So 1 plus. 6, six that's 7
D8? Is this going to be like when RoboCop got massacred?
11
to shreds, you say?
13 17
string time, everybody.
17 plus
8 fan favorite coming up here.
25
25.
Outstanding.
Okay, so the guard over there takes
finish him.
25 damage. He is bloodied, but he is not out.
Wow, these guys are resilient.
It is now Jack O'Gani's turn.
It's been 84 years.
You have never seen that movie.
I have not. What movie? Is it Gone with the Wind?
No, it's Titanic.
It's Titanic.
It's Titanic.
Hey, question.
Yeah, sure.
From the main lobby, is the door to the hallway where the guards are open?
Yes, the wall is now gone. The wall holding the door is now gone.
Fair. So I'm just going to strut into the main lobby and unload on the first two guards that are there.
I fucking love that idea. Let's.
Are you going to shoot at them, though?
Yeah. Could you please place your character where you're at? You see your character on the board. I just kind of want to get a sense to where you're at or where you're coming through. Okay. Yeah. And you're just unloading on these two there. Yeah, sure. You got a rifle pointed at each one, I assume.
And
yes?
To clarify, yes, I will also be shooting my rifles at them.
Just coming.
Okay. Okay. So this is going to be fucking great. I want you to roll with advantage.
Can we just say unload one more time?
Be great.
You've done a lot of unloading today. First you and Pinnaman in the file cabinet, and then you just, you know, let loose.
I mean, I'm
with
so glad everyone is just okay with us. You know, making
oh, it's
our,
great. Yeah, no, movie. It's awesome. Yeah.
It smells great in there.
Glitch has been on the couch not participating in any of this this entire time.
I'm surprised by that. Glitch is useless.
Well, and Glitch was also watching you and Pinnaman, so it was like, well, there you go.
Sylvania's still hiding behind the desk
in the corner.
I mean, if he had
he was enjoying
he
a juice box.
Fingers, wouldn't you?
That's a, yeah, exactly.
I mean, we're not that close to it. Like, just ask first.
I'm just not surprised that Jack O'Gani is horny.
Mm. Oh my God. All right.
It's just like straight men with their pigtails, dude.
Exactly. Let's roll that beautiful bean damage because you definitely got it. And if you can distinguish kind of which guard gets how many damage. Stan with the Hancock glasses.
Left guard 5 damage, right guard 10 damage.
Nice, thank you very much. All right, give me a moment here. Left guard.
Finish him.
This one gets... Alright. You the guards are looking around in this cloud of white smoke that's gathered around in the main lobby when they see in the distance the glow from your lighted up horns. Just kind of Godzilla style in the distance before they see shots just ring out. They appear to be coming from the smoke itself and pierce out, bloodying up the two guards in front of you here. They are bloodied, but they are not out. It is now Pinnaman's turn. Pinnaman, what are you doing?
I would like to take this opportunity take a Princess Peach leap into the air and float through the main lobby and pop off a shot at each of the remaining guards.
You will not be able to Princess Peach style this because, again, in this particular realm, your light jacket acts as a speed jacket, not a feather fall jacket.
I did not.
But you can, much like the Flash, go through this lobby and very much surprise the rest of them.
I do have two daggers. So actually, just like the Flash, I would like to just take my daggers out, and as I pass through them, hopefully slice them in half.
I love this. I want you to roll with advantage because this sounds like a good idea, and you've got the jacket. So, like, you know, logistically, I think this makes sense.
I mean, I have three that I could go through as of right now if I can just, like, high-five Belarus on the way by.
Wonderful.
Definitely
roll, like Superman.
Yeah, definitely roll with advantage. I could just... Four. Did you say 24, you say?
I said 24.
Outstanding.
You managed to, I'm going to give you +5 damage, to go along. You are able to reach all three and head to where Leolin is now. If that's where you were going with this. Cause again, you said you're using your daggers. You're going to be chopping at all three of them as you're zooming past them.
Because there is a cloud, do I get my sneak attack?
Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, nobody could see shit. You guys are, like, moving around super fast, so yeah, sure, that makes sense. Holy shit.
Outstanding.
Right, yeah.
Sure. You. What?
53?
Yeah, that shit happened, thing, guys. Right?
Unreal. Right? Okay, give me just a moment here. Wait.
Absolutely not.
You have 10 seconds to take your turn.
Exactly. Fatality.
I figured I'd take the risk. All right.
Apparently, you have to know what your jacket does, guys. Sorry about.
Yeah, you. I'm gonna move your character as I go ahead and explain what happens. You, through this cloud of smoke, take out your daggers, put on your leather jacket, and you can feel time start to slow around you as you quick zip past the first two guards. You manage to take a dagger and stab one right below the base of the neck. And then another through the back of its head before spinning around and getting this one's neck directly. As you take out his Adam's apple and then shove it down his own throat, you push him aside and you stroll past Belarus, who is still holding his rifles, and sees, because he's able to see, because he's wearing the jacket, your form kind of wink at him as he goes by. He drops his guard, he drops his rifle briefly and reaches his hand out. You two slap skins, and he, as the rifle is falling, he picks it back up and places it back where it belongs. As you move past and get to this other guard, the guard only sees a streak before time catches up with him, and he sees you in front of him. You manage to take both of your daggers, spin them around Loki style, and stab this guy in the head on each side, taking him out indefinitely. But because you did it at such a force with your speed, his head also just explodes, scanner style. you have taken out three guards.
Woo! What do we call? Is it crimson mist? What was that?
A fine blue digital mist.
I kind of like that crimson mist though. That's kind of
yeah. That's pretty good.
It's like a mystery novel title or something.
Yeah, we're gonna have to travel back in time to our old bar and rename it.
And just so we're clear, the streak that the last guard saw was just the streak on the toilet paper that was on Belarus's
country.
It is now.
Give me a moment.
Belarus's turn. Belarus, what are we doing?
So I just got to say how perfect Peniman's action was there.
That was pretty good.
Right. The whole time I was thinking what I wanted to do was light jacket wall walk across this area like Prince of Persia.
And I like that.
It seems like that would fit in perfectly with what just happened with that string of actions. And I'm super excited that that happened. So let's say after I got my high five and caught my rifle again, he's going to run and light jacket wall walk across this wall right here, all the way to this area. And while doing so, pointing the shots rifle
at the,
at this guy and this guy.
Okay. I like that.
High five and he's like, what a great idea. My turn.
Roll with advantage, obviously, because I think this sounds like a really cool idea that you've done. Plus the fact that you're utilizing your feather fall jacket is very nice. Give me that roll and then we'll see what kind of fucking fucked up shit you're doing.
should be Dex, right?
Yeah, should be Dex.
With advantage?
Dex with avantage.
Avantage? Ooh, I like
with
that.
With an avantage.
Or as the French would say, advantage.
Advantage.
Or as the French would say, orange and blue.
Ménage à toi.
Oui, oui.
Nice.
Outstanding.
You managed to pull this off. I'm going to give you +3 to go with the damage that you're about to roll.
Oh, I like it.
Yeah, all just right. Roll that beautiful bean damage.
So let's go. Guy on the left is going to get...
Yeah, if you could distinguish it off with a L number, R number, that would be...
Copy that.
That would help me out a lot.
Hang on, baby. I got a dirty 22.
Dirty 22 coming for you.
Nice.
Hey there, lady. I got a dirty 22.
Dirty 22 come right at
please,
you.
Please keep it away from me. Oh, okay, no.
all right. That's...
All right.
You have managed to matrix walk up this wall, basically, and do a cool side flip as you walk run across this wall. As you ran across, you are also pointing your pistols. You manage to get a couple shots off, one to the leg, one to the shoulder, one to the ear, one to the side, kind of where the kidneys are and stuff like that. You pistol off these shots. You have bloodied them even further. They are bloodied but not out.
Man, those guys are resilient.
Yeah. Jericho, it's your turn.
First off, I'm naked, so I'd like I don't know if I could throw on a jacket or something. Just like get a little bit decent because Silver's in the same room and it was kind of cold when I came out of the couch. just so we're clear.
I was at the pool.
I was in the pool.
So yeah, definitely in all the commotion, I want to go ahead. So this guy that's right in front of the door there, he's still alive.
Which one?
Give me one second. Let me see. Oh no. Okay, I guess he's not there. Okay, I'm looking on my owl bear, and it's different than yours. Okay.
Yeah, sorry. If it's grayed out, it should be grayed out, the guy in front
of you.
You
know what? Fuck it. Don't put any clothes on me. I burst through that fucking door there, and I just aim both my rifles at the left and the right, and I'm just going to just go ahead and blast away naked as it came.
Okay. Let's. I'm not going to give you advantage because at this point the wall is gone. There's
yeah, no, that's fine. I'm
naked.
I don't expect much
But, yeah, so roll dexterity, please.
All right, here we go.
or
something. Okay, well, that's... you managed to... all over the place. But your shots, well, they ring off a couple of different directions, including pinging off of Sylvia's arm as she blocks one of your misled shots. It does not deal any damage to the thugs.
Just like spaghetti noodle arms. It's like, I'm sweaty. I'm sorry.
Leolin, it's your turn.
Hang on. Wait, quick. I was in the bathroom, but naked as he came, name of your sex tape.
Giggity.
That is pretty perfect. Yeah.
Works. Mine's Alpha levels. Dog.
Definitely a good one.
That's weird. Leland, what are you doing?
I'm going to go up here. And shoot
directly
through the door, directly at these two. Okay. Hopefully I hit him on the way.
There's a door in front of...
the door's not open?
No, the door's not open. It activates via, like, somebody has to, like, stand in front of it in order for the door to swing open Star Trek. All right,
I'll just shoot this guy.
Okay, that makes sense. Let's roll that dexterity.
I mean, I'm probably not going to shoot that guy.
Well, yeah, we'll see what happens here.
Yeah, I'm not going to shoot that guy. I'm not shooting him.
So what are you doing? Just move
in. I can't do anything. My turn's over.
Okay. Well, that's all right.
Got a six.
Okay. You again start ringing off some shots, but the man ducks behind the wall, and you are able to just ring shots past his face, but not directly at him.
It's a good thing Belarus is trailing TP, because you just shit your pants.
Right. Sylvair pops out her mantis blade and jumps over Jericho through to the right guard, and she manages to pop out her second mantis blade, stabbing this man both in the head and in the stomach, ending his life. So she has taken out one guard. Hooray. It is now Elceris's turn.
Elceris. Which, okay, that guy's dead? Okay.
Yeah.
Man,
Ben Kniff's turn.
Oh yeah, you like that?
Stop it! Stop it right now, Stan.
Kenneth
from Connecticut.
Can
El Sarah see through the wall, and see those two people in the elevator lobby?
No,
like
not from where he's at.
Well, like if I got closer to the wall.
Yeah, please move the character, and then I can
face
better...
up against the wall. I don't want to go through yet.
If I went to here,
yes, you can see the people behind the wall.
I think that's okay, a bar, well, isn't should... it? Isn't that a bar?
You're able to see their silhouette, but you're not able to hack them.
Can I scream? Can I sonic scream at them?
Yes, but there is a wall in front of you, so you're. Scream would have to penetrate the wall into the room.
Penetration.
Hey, right.
Yeah. Okay, so then I'm gonna move. I would like to like cover some distance, and while covering some distance, I want to dual wield shoot this dude here.
Mm-hmm.
Get him out the way, and I think he can move 30-ish. I'm going to move to... Elceris is going to run across. I see that there's a guard, and I shoot him as I run all the way to here. with my dual-wielding rifles, because overkill.
All right, makes sense. I'm going to say you leapfrog over Jericho, and then do a spinning jump kick over this guard
And as you are doing your spinning jump kick, you are also pulling out your rifle to shoot at him. So I'm going to give Alceris advantage on that.
Is that a dex?
Yeah, that's a dex with advantage.
Okay, we got 18. Ooh, yeah, we'll take the 18.
Nice.
Outstanding.
You managed to pull off all six shots riddling into this poor guard. Let's roll that beautiful bean damage.
Okay, we're gonna do a D8 times 6. That's a lot of dice. 28. All those dice.
Outstanding. 28.
And you managed to kill this fucking guy.
You gotta be dead.
All right, so, and that guy should be dead too. Yeah, no, that guy. All right, and so you have killed off one more guard. And as you riddled him with bullets, he fell down dead as fuck, and you managed to put yourself on the other side. It is now... Oh, is it Thug's turn? Well, the only Thug that you have here is the one with Leolin, who can see you guys anyway. So, the guard only has a pistol. He fires his one shot, and he misses Leolin. It is now Ivana's turn.
What does Ivana do?
Leolin, what does Ivana do?
You're okay?
She coughs.
She starts blasting.
Yeah, all right. She starts blasting. Let's roll that dex.
Plus 3, 15.
Outstanding.
Yeah, she manages to pull off those shots. Let's go ahead and roll that beautiful bean damage.
Fuck this shit. I'm not going to roll 8d8. I'm going to click this button.
Yeah. Click that button. Fuck that noise.
Way easier with a digital dice when you need, like, big quantities.
Yeah,
37.
Yeah. Nice.
Outstanding.
She pulls out her rifles and just starts blasting away. And because she does all this blasting, pierces him on the side, gets him in the dick, gets him in the, head a couple of times, and he's fucking down. So now, you guys have only the two guards by the elevators who are left. It is now Jekyll Ghani's turn. Jekyll Ghani, what are you doing?
I would like to spend my turn thanking the shrubbery who passed in its sacrifice to allow all of this to happen.
That's noble.
Amidst all this stuff that's going on, you go back into the room. There's sad music that's playing as time starts to slow down a little bit. You walk over to the plant that is now busted and on the floor and a little bit crispy because of all the burning that's happened. You find the bit of branch that hasn't been completely singed, and you wrap it up in the ashes and dirt that have spread across the floor itself. You make a nice circle. You give thanks to the life of the plant itself. And a slow tear slides from your right cheek, and it lands on the bit of unburnt branch. You cover this branch with dirt, pat it down, and then walk away from it. Mother Gaia sufficiently pleased.
Let it be known that I took a knee and bowed my head during all of that.
Okay, great. Silver was checking her nails.
Goddamn paladins.
You guys are not giving a shit about that.
Fucking paladins.
I love when they do that shit when I say paladin.
It is now Pinnaman's turn. Pinnaman, what are you doing?
Hey, DM, question for you.
Yes.
Am I allowed with my jacket to, I know you said these doors are Star Trek-y.
Uh-huh.
So what does that mean for my speed attack if I want to flash my way into that room and surprise them?
I'm going to give you advantage on that because I would feel like your jacket, much like when the Flash shows up to the thieves' bank robbery heist in the middle of their heist and goes, well, this money doesn't seem like your guys's. And then they try to shoot at the guy. The Flash still has enough speed to kind of move out of the way of the bullets. So I'm going to say that you are allowed to not only like slow down enough to have the door open up, but get inside here without them being able to quickly draw upon you.
Cool. Since I'm pretty agile, I would love to when the door opens, I would love to just slide between the legs of the first one, and you know, instead of praying like my good friend Jack O'Ghani, who is me, that's clearly what he's doing right now.
Right.
That poor guy.
Yeah.
I have to just like kneel and just like lift up.
With both just like on the Gucci.
Just on my knees and
lift up
to the heavens.
Let me do a couple of calculations here.
Theme of the night, on my knees.
40. You have about 70. Okay, I'll give you advantage.
Okay, great.
I'm looking at this and I feel like, yes, you're able to cross this amount of distance with your jacket, plus get to the where you need to be with like at least 10 feet to spare.
So the light jacket gives him the power to phase through doors, but not walls.
He did not phase through the door. He simply went to the door, stopped, waited for it to open, and while he had enough room to move inside,
okay.
Was able to kind of use his speed to go between.
So no phasing whatsoever.
So no phasing whatsoever. An advantage 24.
Ooh.
Outstanding.
I'm going to give you a plus three to damage.
Clarify, this is holy sanctity with my knives, not rifles.
Oh, shit. Okay. This is...
Gooch has been touched.
Wow. Let's do the... Yeah, no, I'll still give you a damage advantage, plus three. I shouldn't. Yeah, let's see what kind of damage you do. Jesus.
Uh, 13 altogether.
Okay. And despite the fact that you took just like slice after slice to his gooch and balls, he was pierced, but he's not out. And he's not even bloody, merely that's flesh terrible. Wounds across his gooch and balls. Yeah, that's
good question. I forgot to calculate. Is this a sneak attack?
No.
They see this coming at all?
Right in the middle of the guy's gooch. Like, I imagine that's pretty sneaky, sis. Let's do... Fuck it. Yeah. I forgot what that even means. What is that? More damage, basically?
And another 9. Yeah.
You get him real good in the gooch, and he starts bleeding from his bottom portion, his lower half, if you will. Yeah, he is bloodied from the waist down.
I mean, that's where we're hanging out tonight, right?
I can dig it.
low it is, hanging fruit.
Yeah, pretty there much. Belarus, it's your turn.
Low rider.
It's all with right. The fur, with the fur.
So just to double check, the light jacket doubles my range, speed. Right?
Yeah, speed and range.
Okay, fantastic. That's good news.
I just want to go ahead and point this out again. In this realm,
yes,
this
yes,
is what the light jacket does.
Yeah, thank you for point or you know making sure. So I was able to see Penniman use his light jacket to get into the next room, and I decide I shall do the same. So he's gonna run into the room and I guess just start blasting. And I
think move your character to where your character would be once he's inside of this room.
I would love to. So bop, 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 bop. And then like maybe here and hit a corner. Pull out my keytar. No. Pull out my dual rifles.
It sounds like a mandolin. Like how
does this happen? Yeah. But like an electric mandolin. I don't know how you do that, but like yeah, sure.
Synthesize all kinds of shit. It's crazy.
I could dig it. Neon synth wave. I could dig it. Let's definitely do that. I'm gonna give you advantage because this is pretty sneaky. Yeah. This is pretty sneaky, sis.
Outstanding.
All right.
That's enough.
Yeah, that's good. Let's roll that beautiful bean damage. Well, you had it with the 17. All right, let's not go away.
Outstanding.
Well, come on, but you said I get advantage, so let me.
Yeah, what if no. I had, so what if all I right, you, I'll give you a +3 to your damage.
All right,
damn, give me some shit.
+3. All right. So 6d8. Doot. Wow, settle down. Calm down. For one. All right, 18, 19,
20, 21. Nice.
Outstanding.
Let's see. Okay, all right.
Is he bloody?
Give me a moment. You have managed to put a shot through the head on the guard on the right, and you hear ooh, headshot before guard falls to the ground dead. You have killed off and you have killed off yet another guard. The other one is
bit?
Yeah, sure, hang on. Ooh, headshot.
Thank you.
Yeah, and so you have killed off one guard. The other one is still standing. It is now. Fuck. Give me a moment. It's now Jericho's turn. Jericho, what are you doing?
I'm naked.
I'd like to. Shit. I don't even know if I can make it in that room. I love how he X'd out the tree.
Yeah, that's RIP tree. That? RIP shrub.
Okay.
No, so, there's no way you could get into this room from where you're
there's
at.
There's no way. I'd like to take this. I'd like to take this round too.
I did that like 15 minutes ago.
That was pretty funny, man. I also saw that and I didn't comment on it because like, oh God, this is beautiful.
It's absolutely wonderful. I'd like to take this opportunity to put my clothes on and I guess pass to the next person closest, which is probably Elceris, I think, or something. I don't know. Whoever's next. Yeah.
It is now Leolin's turn.
There you go.
You slowly, much like somebody who just auditioned for Walt Disney, slowly put your clothes back on. You're slightly ashamed, but you know that this is all for your career, and you are going to eventually like yourself, hopefully in the end. So
I'm just like I'm putting it on, like I guess it technically worked.
The
frozen
not the
guy.
People that made Soul and Raya and the Last Dragon. No, that's not what
like,
I meant.
I was like,
Pixar had nothing to do with this. No, I didn't.
John
I didn't
Lasseter
mean to.
Would never.
Yeah,
they're in a whole different studio.
Yeah. No, that's no. It's the man, the person, Walt Disney. Yeah.
But, I like put it on.
Awful
like,
man,
like,
even though he gave us Pinocchio. It's, you know, I can understand. Lady and the Tramp.
He
I
gave us
that.
A toy that grows wood. Wonderful.
It's wonderful, I guess.
It's also a child, if we have to point that out.
He turned into a donkey as well in the film. So, I mean, like, what? A lot of shit was weird about that.
Leyland, what are we doing?
Oh, I was just waiting for
right
to finish
in
your dissertation man. About Pinocchio and Walt
Thanks.
Disney.
This is weird, you guys.
I'm going to try shooting the remaining guard right in the face.
Nice. I'm going to give you a advantage. I mean, like you guys have three people on him. He has been shot. At this point, he has only
That's
one rifle with him. Yeah, he's got a shot in his fucking face.
Bullshit.
You put the rifle close to his head, and you hear the shot ring off, but the bullet apparently just goes to the left of the guard's head and does not actually kill him at all. That's weird. Silver.
That was with your advantage, Carl.
That was with advantage.
I got
an
8 and a 7.
Wowzers.
Spectacular. That's still better than the 4s I've been rolling tonight.
It's pretty fucking stupid.
Silver.
Our bad rolls out. What is wrong?
Exactly. El Saris, what are you doing?
I see that I'm in range. To go 20 here and 10 here.
Mm-hmm.
I run up to the door. It goes swoosh. Then I enter the door.
Or how Star Trek noise is.
And I see that there is one guard surrounded by three of my companions. Mm-hmm. And then
Bukkake
I say to myself, hotshot.
Oh, shit.
And then and then my scythe goes hot shot
and I want you
I'll
to
use my credit card
I'll use my credit card
it's not very PC. I guess they won't have a problem seeing the ball with their big American eyes.
You're gonna get us in trouble again.
I want you to roll wisdom with or no he's a bard charisma with advantage please.
Fantastic. Ooh, gotta like that. I'll take that.
Outstanding.
His HUD inside of his head says hot shot. And there are lights that start to form Godzilla style in his neck. As a fire starts to erupt from his neck. Executioner style, he opens up his mouth wide and a fireball basically produces from his mouth into the opening guard's mouth because the guard is so shocked and awed by what he's saying. Yeah, he's ah! And as the mouth is open, the ball gets into the other person's mouth and erupts flare style within his head. You see the back of this guard's eyes start to just become encased in flame. And he starts to grab at his own head before the inner cooking starts to happen.
And yeah, there is a burnt to the crisp head that happens with this guard. He is fucking dead.
Outstanding.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what Hotshot does. So I guess... You guys have killed everybody else in this room, which is great. let's show them what they won, Johnny.
14 guards, 1 hour, 100 XP.
You each get 250 XP, as well as 250 credits each, plus 10 pistols. Because fuck it, why not?
And unlike so this is called cyberpunk. Let's just call it that. It's
cyber- yeah, that makes sense. Yeah.
Do any of these cyberpunk pistols vary in customization, or are they just fucking regular black Glocks? I mean, like, what are we looking at here?
Yeah,
I mean, no, obviously they're pink.
We're looking at German Lugers.
Sorry.
You said it. You said it. You said it. Cyber pink. They gotta be pink.
Yeah, no, it makes sense. It makes sense though.
All right. They're pink, but they're a flesh pink.
Oh, they should be they should be like fluorescent pink.
Like, yeah, no, I don't like that peach pink. No.
Like, no, they're like a they're like a penis pink. And
because like they're so many different colors.
No, it's definitely flesh pink. And it's you they're flesh pink Lugers.
Are all penises pink?
Lugers. Yes. Apparently. Or at least that's what I was told. That's the internet hasn't been kind to me.
Mean, Jekko's is purple from what I remember. But, I mean, y'all didn't take a look when
With all that furry porn you got off the computer, couch. I imagine you could find at least a couple of purples and pinks in there. I don't know. I don't know what's going on.
I digress.
Sorry, I'm getting off topic. Anyway, so you guys have killed everybody else in this room. And Glitch goes to the elevators, opens it up, and you guys are heading into the second level of the second level of the penthouse suite near Osaka Tower. Give me a moment.
I'm surprised nobody investigated when a giant hole opened up in the floor up there.
Right. What's going on down there?
Let's see. As you are in the elevator, the Kidz Bop version of Bruno Mars's Grenade starts to ring off. It's very
popular in McGainis.
Yes, it's very loud and popular.
So wait, I got a question before we proceed. So, speaking of the explosion, so when I consider the nine levels of hell, expect us to go down until we get to like, you know, like nine is up here and then like five is up here and then one is that a correct thinking?
You're thinking of this as hell. Stop it. Okay. There's only five levels. But yeah, there's a top level and then it goes down.
Well, I'm trying to figure out if the explosion that we had that caved in the floor, does that affect the levels?
No, it shot up. So it's affecting level two. Or penthouse level two rather.
Okay.
But not the floor below it.
All right.
Yeah. Okay.
Is this the hive from Umbrella Corp?
Can you not?
I have a question for the group. Like all these unresolved pistols, I guess two questions. Should we just
can we make a mechanical man out of these pistols?
We could. Could we?
Not
we
a just bad idea. At
the end and you know we can just divvy up the gold.
I thought we were just supposed to throw the pistols at people, like they were the weapon. Just throw it.
Right.
I mean, how many pistols did we use to do our distraction? I mean, like, because that's.
I was hoping we were just using bullet ammo, but we did throw some guns in, I guess. So whatever.
Silver threw at least 10 pistols. I feel
like we have like 25 pistols. We have.
I wasn't serious. That's a little much.
I feel like we should just keep using them to blow shit up.
And just I don't like, think.
Yeah, that's it's great.
Honestly, it's been good to us so far.
Yeah, a month ago. Like, how many pistols?
Yeah, but not good for the plan.
Right. It wasn't good for the plant.
That's true. I mean,
there we have spider shoes and a bunch of other
stuff. This is the worst. Like,
pistols? Or plants?
Plants.
Oh.
Sorry, I'm trying to get the map already.
No one cares. It's fine. Don't worry about it.
What happened? What?
Steve, you have enough plants.
That poor plant. It didn't ask for any of this.
I know, right? Like, I wasn't even here to defend it.
You know what? You know what's crazy? Neither did Crystal.
Right.
Crystal,
we, yeah, we didn't mourn for Crystal.
And you, at poor Crystal.
Too soon.
At poor Crystal.
So, does Jekyll Ghani still have all that really fancy stuff from before, such as the Sword of Sharpness and the Dagger of Venom? Oh.
Yes.
Okay.
It's in his pocket, actually.
In his digital inventory, yeah.
In his digital inventory.
Oh, yeah, shit. Sorry. Thank you. Fuck, I was supposed to... I'm so bad at this.
All this gosh darn technology. Yeah,
please don't ever be a first-time DM. This sucks. You guys make this a lot of fun, but oi.
Oi. Did you give away some secrets I missed? Do it again.
No, I just...
on Discord.
The if you're in the owlbear thing, which you should be, I apologize, I fucked that up. You guys have entered into the second level. The red paint stain that I've got there is supposed to mark a door.
Mm-hmm.
So that is where you guys entered into. There is a shrub that you see in the middle of the room, just like the shrub that was downstairs in level one.
That's not long for this world.
Yeah. You see where the wait? I should point out, you see where the waiting room is?
Yeah.
There is a big, long table in the middle of this waiting room. That table is gone and replaced with a big, large hole leading into level two. Or to level one.
Oh, we should have jumped up the fucking hole and... well, whatever.
Thank you very much. And there's a Dorito chip now in the middle of the room. And there was...
What flavor is it?
It's Cool Ranch.
Barely nacho cheese.
Yeah,
come on.
What the fuck? What kind of question pretty, like, is that?
Should I say spicy nacho? Is that going to go ahead and appease
everyone? The extra nacho cheese one.
The extra nacho cheese. It's flavor blasting. Fuck,
I dug that shit out of a Taco Bell dumpster for you guys.
Yeah, it tastes like Taco House flour tacos. Mmm, yum.
Deep fried, right?
Deep fried. Oh, hell yeah.
Okay, thank you.
So you guys are in this room. Run for initiative!
Oh, shit. Surprise.
Like a natural one.
Let's see. Who flashed at the
outstanding?
Huh?
Well, Carl, you're in good company. I also rolled a nat one on this initiative.
Like, maybe this will go better because last time I rolled a natural 20 for initiative.
Three.
Outstanding.
Natural one. That's a.
Finish him.
It is now Belarus's turn. Belarus, what are we doing?
It's a good question. What's going on?
Okay. You have entered into the second level here. The stairs again don't have been shut off to you. Let's just say they're regular doors that have been locked. You are supposed to be making your way towards the elevator.
Making my way towards the elevator. All right.
I'm out down till I'm down in Hobart. Dun dun nacho cheese. Dun 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 nacho cheese.
All right. I feel like I. So we rolled.
That's what should have been playing in the elevator.
They're already attacking us. So I guess we just need to start blasting people. I'm going to aim one rifle to the left and one to the right. You know, get things started.
All right. No advantage on this one this time. Let's roll that dexterity, please.
That's fair. We gave ourselves lots of notice. Ah, yeah, you're going to love this. Oh, God.
You threw off those shots again with the rifles, so you ring off three different shots, but the guards managed to duck out of your bullet paths and drop to the ground, missing all of your bullets.
Yeah, essentially.
Yeah, it is Pinnaman's turn now. Pinnaman, what are we doing?
Well, I would just like to try to, shoot one rifle towards the right guy and one rifle towards the left guy.
All right, let's roll that dexterity.
Outstanding. That's fine. I didn't add my bonus, but that's fine. If 13 is outstanding.
It got it. That's three shots to the left, three shots to the right. That's beautiful. I'm going to give you a plus three because you're so close. Boy, digital dice, huh?
Just 10 minutes of the Star Wars.
Yeah.
10 hours.
Could you imagine if we were doing this like IRL?
28 altogether. How would you like to divvy that out?
I'm going to give half to each, basically. I think that seems fair.
It's coming up.
So.
Fatality.
Sub-zero.
Fatality.
You manage to clip them in the shoulders and in the legs, but they are hit but not out. It is now Silver's turn. Silver pops open her Magus Blade, leapfrogs over Pinnaman as well as over Leolin, and manages to slice through the head of the guard of the right. Killing him instantly.
Instantaneous.
One guard is down, and let's see. Yeah, she's over here. Okay, and so that is her turn. Elceris, what are you doing?
Oh yeah, Elceris. Elceris is going to...
Let me go ahead and point out who you can see here. You can see this person.
Yeah.
And you can see this person. And you can see this person. You cannot see this person.
Okay.
You see how your range is kind of like limited, yeah?
Yeah.
And still got a hell of an advantage there.
The doors aren't open. I could blast them down with a sonic wave.
You could.
I could. Let's see if there's any reason we'd want to do that. It looks like no. At the moment. I would like to move closer to this guy and try to sonic blast from here and then be able to see this guy. And blah, blah, blah.
Okay. I'm going to say you are trying to move to around like this area. Yes?
Will I be able to blast both of them? Because like either I don't
care. You would be in the line of sight of this guy, but you would be only able to get this guy. Or sorry.
So what if I was here and I like yelled through his face at this angle?
Give me a moment. Yeah, all right, I'll give it to you.
That's what I'd like to do. I'd like to do that.
Okay, let's roll a wisdom with advantage.
Okay.
A charisma with advantage.
I knew what you meant. No worries. All right, I like the advantages. Okay. First one's 15. Give me something better. 13. Looks like we're going with the 15.
Outstanding.
Your mouth transforms, opens up wider, and a
a blue speaker pops up in the middle of your esophagus and amplifies this piercing, harmonious wave of sound that echoes throughout the entire floor. I'm going to give you plus 5 to damage. So let's see what happens when you do that.
So the guy closest to me gets, 18? And then the furthest guy gets 22.
Oof, nice. All right. you let loose with this black canary scream. And much like Sindel when she screamed into the ear of her opponent for her fatality, the bones of this person rattle around within their body and escape their joints and sockets to where they are attached. And because of this, the spine no longer supports the rest of the body. This particular person crumbles to the ground, dead as fuck. You have also managed to bloody up this individual. This individual here. I don't know how you want to mark that down. You have gotten two people. One is fucking dead. The other one is bloodied. It is now Ivana's turn. Leolin, what is Ivana doing?
I think she's going to start blasting.
Nicely done. Is she moving at all or no?
Yeah, I think she should move up so she can see people.
Okay. Do you have owlbear or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Move Ivana to where she's supposed to be.
Is that her?
Can't see where you're... Oh, yep, there she is. Yes, okay, that's so where it is. All right, if that's where she's supposed to be, then good. I will give... Oh, hang on for me 1 second, because you might have moved a little bit farther than she's able to...
Oh.
Yeah, I'm gonna say you're able to move around like about 30 feet, maybe even 35, I'll give you. I'll say you're about here.
Okay.
Okay. You're dual wielding, yes?
So can she not see this guy?
She cannot see that guy because the guy in front of her is blocking.
But what if she tries to... If she's dual wielding, like, what if she shoots a hole through his head and then uses her other rifle to shoot a bullet through that hole to hit this guy?
I like where your head's at with this one. I want to say it kind of depends on if she's able to cap this guy off. Yeah. So I'm not going to give you advantage. I want you to roll a dexterity and then see what happens.
I mean, I'm guessing none of this is going to happen.
Probably not.
That'd be a 11.
The shots ring out, even though the gun is pointed very close to the guard's head.
Was that with her plus 3, Carl?
Correct.
Oh, great. Okay.
The shots manages to just kind of graze past the guard's head and don't actually hit any of them. It is now guard's turns. Let's see. The one in front of Ivana is going to shoot at Ivana.
Outstanding.
And is definitely going to hit. Hang on for me 1 second. Oi. She gets 3. No, he's only got... Does he have a rifle? 8 pistols. No, he's only got a pistol. So, 1d8.
BTW, Years and Years has a new song out. Robert?
I will listen to that on the way to work tomorrow.
Ivana's got 7 that she's hit with. I don't know how anybody wants to mark that down. If you can't find her thing, that's fine. I'll
put it in the notes.
Yeah, just put it in the notes. I'm sure she's going to be fine. Yeah, so she gets hit for 7. The other guards are starting to come out of their rooms. Okay. Yeah, so the guards are starting to pile on up out of their official rooms that they were at and starting to make their way towards the crew. Jericho, it's your turn.
Well, I zip up my pants.
Now that I'm clothed, I'm a little bit more comfortable. I'd like to, let me see how far. Okay. I want to move up by Ivana and go ahead and start popping off shots to that. Because we just have to get to the elevator, right? I mean, that's the main thing, right?
Yep.
Seems like it.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, we don't have to actually slaughter everybody on this entire floor?
I guess correct. Not. I miss XP, but, you know.
Yeah. It's a, unless you want the XP. Yeah. That's the.
I mean, to get Earl, have you ever played a video game? If they're not all dead, you didn't play the game.
Right.
I have to check. I need to kick in every single vase to make sure there's not bullets inside.
What do you think?
For...
There could be a hidden rupee you don't know about.
Yeah, I want to open every drawer of every desk.
It's all furry porn. We've established that, right. This canon.
Let's.
I want one of those glasses, please. Where did you get?
Yeah, no shit, right? He's talking to you, Stan.
Oh, I was like glasses. Oh, my goggles.
Yeah, I want these, your glasses.
Your Hancock goggles.
Right. You know what? I got this from one of those Halloween costume stores. I was like, oh, goggles, and they have. Can you see the little symbol? It's got the biohazard symbol.
I cannot, but it sweet. Still looks fun.
Yeah, no.
Oh, hey, fun.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Well, thank you.
Digging.
Thank you.
I pop off shots. So
okay, great. I'm gonna say you move up to Ivana. You start popping off shots. Roll a dexterity, please. Oh.
Outstanding.
Yeah, no, you definitely have some of these shots going on here. So done. Let's.
I think I can only see the first.
You can only see the first person. So let's roll for damage, please. You're very close to him as well. So I'm going to give you a +5 for damage.
Oh, okay. Okay, let's see what we get.
Risky business.
That's jamming.
Okay, really?
Outstanding.
So with your advantage, that's okay. Well, that's not all right.
Yeah.
I guess damage is damage. Yeah. These are the
you shot both guns at the one guy, right?
The ones that just say bang. Yeah, you should have like
that's like less than minimum damage, bro.
Yeah, right. that's 6 shots that you did.
Oh shit, that's right. I'm sorry. Right. I keep forgetting.
I'm like 3D8. That doesn't
mean 1D6. Man, that's some risky business right there.
Hey, oh, risky. Give me
2 more, and then we'll be good, and we'll add it all together.
Risky business.
I love it. That's a great song.
It's not much better.
This is altogether the damage?
3d8s.
6. Wow. 6. You're dual wielding.
Oh, fuck. I'm so sorry.
No, I'm...
I'm so sorry.
I just want you to have every advantage that you have that I am willing to give you. Like.
So 11 and 17. What do we got here? 28. All right.
Okay. Told, yeah. No. Told. That's beautiful. All right.
Time is hard.
You managed to riddle this guy up with bullets until you hear a
ooh, headshot,
and a shot goes through the guard's head. Because of this, a shot that goes through the guard's head,
killing him instantly, you are able to see on the other side this other guard. So your remaining damage is then put into the other guard via the bullet that gets lodged into that way. And this guard over...
put into him.
Yeah, pretty much.
Is it like deposited into his digital inventory?
Nope, yeah. this guy is bloodied. And you have killed this guy. And now we are going to hit Control F. And then we are going to hit Save Game. And this is where we will end tonight's session. Alexa, stop. I want to say thanks again for playing Dungeons & Dragons with me, you guys. It's so much fun to get together on Saturdays. I love playing with you guys. Glad we can do this, and I'm looking forward to actually doing this in the real
world.
Coming soon.
Ooh, headshot.
Ooh, Steve, you're done, right?
I just got my vaccination. Yeah.
Hey. Yeah, I got mine last Thursday.
Mine's next Sunday. But then I got the two dose.
I have my first round on Wednesday.
Nice.
Nice.
I mean, so, I don't so know. Close. I mean, this might need a booster. Who knows? I'm one of those one doses.
You did the JJs?
It'll be fine.
I gave what Target got me.
T-business.
Yeah, I got the J&J too.
Yeah, JD hopefully just got it yesterday, so he's been like laying down with a fever all day.
Yeah, that was me on Friday. Yeah, I was out.
It wasn't fun.
That means...
But back to the DM. Back to the DM.
Oh, sorry. I want you guys to... I want to. I've been checking in with my health partners, people.
Did you sign up for the state connector? Because that's how I'm getting mine.
No, I've been doing it through my health partners app. And they told me they're just going to send me a thing.
Yeah, so my health thing is not doing me yet. If you sign up for the state and sign up for Hennepin County, well, you'll be in Ramsey County, right?
Yeah.
So I bet Ramsey County has one too. So you sign up for the email list and they'll just do like random by zip code.
And I totally want to get it. It seems like everybody's getting it and I want to definitely get mine. But I mean, yeah, it just, I kind of figured I had to wait until I get like a message or something telling me I'm ready to go.
I'll send you the links to the state.
I have to say, so the only way I was able to get it, Kate's dad sent her like just some instructions on how to go through CVS. Mm-hmm. And there's a specific way that you kind of like, you have to do it at like 12 o'clock at midnight and you log in and you're able to, from 12 to 12:10, they just have multiple appointments open. You can just go in and just select one. And it worked for her. And then I saw it and I was like, oh, well, if it worked, let's do it. And so it worked for me too. So, I mean, if you guys want, you want
to
drop
it. I'm going to have to check that out.
Then I can forward it to you at least.
And my wife was saying that her friend had gotten her vaccination and she went through some other website, you know. So
yeah,
there's a myriad of possibilities to go ahead and get your COVID shot. So there's no reason you shouldn't.
Of course, then we have to wait for the bar to open up again.
Exactly. And the movie theaters. God, I can't wait.
Oh, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, I want to see a movie. Oh, hell yeah.
The one that was supposed to come out April last year.
What also, is this movie?
Right.
I've only known Laserdiscs.
Right. if it's not The Voyage of Mimi, I have no idea what it is.
Hey, I had Little Mermaid on Laserdisc. I had Carmen the Opera on Laserdisc.
Ooh,
Beyonce? Laserdisc. Was Beyonce?
Opera, Carmen.
The only thing I've ever seen on Laserdisc was
Terminator 2.
Animation of cell metabolism and biology class.
In science, yep.
I had all I had was Voyager Likewise. Mimi and Terminator 2. I didn't know. Yeah.
It was very porn.
It's the one Laserdisc they shipped around the country.
I think even Ghost Rider, was it Ghost Rider? Did you guys watch that in
school? Oh, yeah.
Ghost Rider. Yeah. That was a great one. Yeah. That was a good one. I think my teacher had that on Laserdisc. I don't know how the fuck she found it, but whatever. All right. Yeah. Let's go ahead and end this fucking game real quick. Hang on one second.
A heart-shaped skull comprised of the fumes of the homebrew rise to meet your gaze as your astral forms plunge out of Tasha's swirling cauldron, out of her realm full of demons and angels, elves and
magic. Dungeons. Oh, goddammit. Dungeons. That happens. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure everybody's... are we good to go for next weekend, everyone?
Oh, I think so.
Let's check your calendar real quick. Yeah, okay. It seems like I'm getting the thumbs up from Stan.
Oh, and... I'm actually not closing. Thank you.
Awesome.
I'm good for next weekend, but the 24th, I'm going to a real live soccer game.
Hey, nice. All right.
Those don't exist, Carl.
Right. It's a little after 7 o'clock game. I don't know when I'm going to be getting home, but I might be able to hop on.
We'll see what happens. If you can make it, awesome. If not, hey, totally understandable. Who would you feel comfortable taking over should you not be able to join?
Anyone.
Okay. That's
if Robert wants to do it, he can.
Sounds good. You don't have a voice or anything, so it makes it semi easy.
Yeah, I tried. That I'm fucking Elfo. Shit won't work. Nah,
you're right. It's all technology's fault.
Does the person who's available? We'll find out.
I fuck up constantly with this shit. Yeah, this is awful. But you know, whatever. I can afford to be dumb. I want to say again, thank you guys for playing with me. This is a super fun Saturday, and I appreciate you guys showing up every Saturday. Cool. So thanks
for being the best DM ever.
I will. I'll see you guys later, and next Saturday. Bye.
Bye. Bye.